it's hot and the drinks are cold. For the women are fine and the men are old. How do you do, folks? Welcome to Cactus Fest. How do you do, folks? Welcome to Cactus Fest.
He says howdy.
Well,
are making Fifi. We're experiencing America from the roads, just like the pioneers did.
See, pioneers drove in a Rolls Royce motorhome.
Anyway, it seems our vehicle broke down a few miles from here. We came to town looking for someone to fix our vehicle.
That's right. Lester just reminded me that Clay Puddle fixes things.
We don't have a real
here. Cactus Fast, but Clay can fix just about anything. He should be coming along here any minute now.
Morning, Sheriff. Lester. Have the Puddles brushed here yet?
No, Miss Halstead. We haven't seen them yet.
Oh, good. I didn't want to be late today. We're having a spelling test. You know, sometimes I get so confused about who I'm teaching when. I had to write a report. Putnam's on Mondays and Wednesdays, Lovell's on Tuesdays and Thursdays, and we alternate Fridays. What a schedule.
Miss Camille Halstead is the school teacher here in Texas Pass. Miss Halstead, this year's the Barrington family. Their car broke down the interview.
Miss Camille.
Miss Halstead, why do you alternate Fridays?
Well, the Putnam's open school for Lovell's, and the Lovell's open school for Putnam's. It has something to do with the few. Anyway, I have to teach two families on different days. I'm better on off now. Miss Camille Halstead.
Well, what have we here? Look, sister, strangers in town.
Well, I declare, we haven't had strangers in town since. Well, since Sheriff Scar came to town 5 years ago.
Wasn't that a wonderful day, sister? I remember it like it was yesterday. The last sheriff had just quit the day before. And who rides into town looking for work?
None other than our own Sheriff Scar. I remember thinking what a handsome young man he was, and how strong and manly
he was. Not this house.
This here's the Barrington family. This is Mr. Trevor Barrington.
The third!
And his wife, Marina. And this is Tiffany, Tina, and Tyler. Miss Morton and Miss Elsie are the mayor's cats.
You have two mayors for this small town?
Why, yes, you see, the Putnam's elected me mayor, and the Ludlow's elected me mayor. They refuse to have the same mayor, so we just share the job. I'm mayor Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays.
And I'm mayor Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays.
Don't tell me you alternate Sundays.
No, the town's closed on Sundays. You hope you're enjoying your stay in Cactus Pass.
Oh, yes, we're having a wonderful
I'm starving!
Is there any place to eat in this town?
Forget eating. I need to get a manicure as fast.
Well, we do have a cute little diner right up the street.
Oh, goody, a diner.
Yes, it's right next to the hotel.
You have a hotel here?
Yes, but nobody stayed there since 1974.
Brandon, dear, why didn't you take the children? I guess I needed the diner. I'll be here for the next part of them.
Well, we'd love to show you where it is. As a matter of fact, we'd love to talk to you. We want to know all about you and your family.
Yes, what a wonderful idea. We'd love to talk to new folks. Why, we just love to talk.
Wonderful. They make it the best.
Maddie, Putt, and this here's my granny.
She's old.
Yeah.
Columbia?
No, ma'am. I come from a long line of Americans from Boston.
Then you're okay.
Bernardo Cassie's got a squirrel early. She's quite a little bookworm.
Yeah, right. He's studying real hard.
Cassie never helps me beat up those sissies, let them girls.
Good. Not those Putnams.
What are you doing in town?
We are going to the general store. What are you doing in town?
The kids are going to school. And we're going to the general store.
It's our turn to go to the general store.
Yeah, you're not supposed to be in town.
Why don't we
all Oh, Bishop, we gotta stick before the Putnams.
A Putnam's a Putnam, no matter how cute you think they are.
That's right, boy. Now you listen to your sisters. Fighting and feuding ain't the Ludlow kind of way, but if it's fighting that you want, well now you've seen your better day. Fighting and feuding is what Putnams do best, so let's have it out right here so we can lay all the rest. This town ain't big enough for both of us to live in. This ain't big enough for both of us to ride. I swear we're never gonna bend, ain't gonna give in. This town ain't big enough for you to run in. Well, knock them out and seal my teeth. Now I'm hearing everything.
That's right. You Putnam girls are mean, not to mention ugly.
You can shut your pop-pop trap with your jaw to sleep. Let me at them. Just let me at them. Why don't this you let those girls fire them mad?
Permission,
Emmett Putnam. Come on, Ma. Let's keep this peaceful.
Tyler, I'm looking for help.
Nice meeting you. This here's my sons, Luke and Lou. And over here are my girls, Nick, Cinda, and Laurie. Go inside, kids. I'll be along in a minute.
Can you come up here and translate?
Lester says Ludlow's took the Barrington on the horse ride to the king. They should be back when? Oh, any minute now.
Well, I took a look at his vehicle.
Wasn't that exciting? The field, the sun in your face, the wind in your hair, the rain's on your head. I felt like Roy Rogers.
I felt like Trigger. The sun brought out my freckles, the wind messed up my hair, and the rains wrecked my nails.
Well, I took a look at your vehicle. It's your ignition.
What's wrong with it?
It broke. I had to call down to El Snow just to order a new one. It could be here in about a week. How is it?
A week? You mean we have to stay in this outhouse for a week? Maybe get me the fan.
Mother!
Dad, please don't
take
care. I'm not
ready. Well, I guess you'd better check into the hotel at the diner. There's the diner up the street. Let's go. We need to freshen up. The Putnams are going to show us how to shuck some corn.
I want to go home!
Shucking corn would be murder on my hands. I think I'll sit this one out. Lester, why don't you ever talk? So you're afraid? Well, what are you afraid of? people laughing at you? Well, I can't imagine anyone laughing at you, Lester.
Things will get better, but they never do. They just never do.
When did the movie start?
It started in 19... 19-
15 and the feud's been going on that long?
Granny Putnam's the only one who really remembers it all. In fact, the annual Cactus Patch Fair race is supposed to be held in a few days. There's a meeting every year to decide whether or not to go on. And every year it turns ugly and it's sad again. Never been to a Cactus Patch Fair. Would you excuse me, Miss Barrington?
Of course.
NASA, we will see you at the town meeting.
Oh, I wouldn't miss it.
Countryside. and meet the real people. I wanted them to feel part of this great land and not know America just for its 5-star hotels and plaza restaurants.
Mastermind us.
I wanted them to experience the cornfields and farms, the swamps and rivers, everything that makes up this great land of ours. I wanted them to meet the teachers and sheriffs, the cowboys and Indians, the farmers and ranchers. I wanted them to see the fruited plains, the mangrove woods, the mountains' majesty. I wanted them to realize that Americans can put aside their differences and form a more perfect union with liberty and justice for all. I wanted them to experience the Cactus Pass Jamboree. Right? Well, what do you say? Don't you want to continue the tradition your forefathers did long ago in the spirit of friendship?
No!
Well, I see. If you want to do the spirit of friendship, will you do it for $5,000 in cash?
Now, let me get this straight. That's $5,000 to buy between amongst themselves?
That's right! To buy it easily amongst the two families! Well, what do you say? Will you do it?
Yeah!
Oh my, what do we do now?
Break out the boats! Break out the boats!
Well, all in favor of holding the cactus, the annual Cactus Pass Jamboree, say aye.
Aye!
For the first time in over 80 years, it looks like the Cactus Pass Jamboree will go on. But I'm so happy, I can just sing.
Have a good night, Sheriff.
haven't seen you before. Come right here. Nobody saw us coming. What's going on, Otis?
Yeah, we're going to stand this way.
Well, I'm going to have you deal with town payroll. But since I've got an even bigger hash for you than that, believe it or not, the Catch and Pass Jamboree is going to take place.
Oh, good. Family fun for everyone.
Forget family fun. It's okay. Oh, I'm so happy. That hoity-toity rich guy. Barrington, well, he's winning $5,000 in the bank tomorrow morning. Seems this has been bribed.
$5,000? So that's a lot of money. Three ways.
You show up at Jamboree, and I will make sure you don't get caught. This bank job is going to be even easier than stealing candy from a baby.
Yeah.
Town will never know we're in cahoots.
Good thinking, Otis. Oh, isn't it nice to have a brother friends?
As long as don't you worry, young brother. You just leave things to little Otis. I always was wild, woolly, and full of mischief. Just like the both of you. Like a dog in the junkyard.
Like a wolf in the fold.
Thank you.
Here, piggy, piggy, piggy. Here, piggy, piggy, piggy. Well, then, Lucinda.
Now, I did see a couple sneers from the crowd. Can a certain Maddie Putnam come up here, please?
Thank you.
Street, so all the youngsters who have signed up for the potato sack race, you're going to come with me. Let's all wish the kids good luck! We can never encourage our youngsters enough. Lester, will you help me?
Come on, bud! Let's get the pants off those sissy
bubbles! Sorry.
In the hen house, we found our pot of gold. I didn't know you were letting your deputy in on the deal.
What are you talking about?
We don't need any more accomplices.
He's not an accomplice. He's a witness. But luckily for us, he's the best kind of witness. A silent one. What are you doing here? You knew about the money and you came to take it back to the town. Well, what'd you think? We were just gonna hand it over to you? It's only a matter of time before you got in my way. Tie him up, Orville, and keep him at your place before I can take him to Mexico. I got some friends in high places there. I can keep him in the Mexican jail for 50 years.
Whatever you say, see you around, little brother.
Wonderful sheriff you are. third word.
Small word.
Sheriff Star is fish. He wants to go fishing with Sheriff Star.
Looks like he's got a big one.
Rod. Real? Reels. Reeler. Really. Sheriff Star is really.
What?
Hey,
Sheriff Star is really a.
This is so exciting.
Me too. I want to see the rest of this country.
I want to see the mountains. Majesty!
You don't know how happy that makes
me. Well, suit yourselves. As for me, I'm leaving. I'm having right this minute. The sooner I'm out of here, the better. Baby, come along. You have a lot of work to do.
Have a nice day.
Monsieur Barrington, don't tell Madame. But I want to come and see children.
We'd be delighted to have you, Fifi. Well, I suppose you'd better go and pack.
Evening, Mr. Barrington.
Evening, kids.
Mr. Barrington, thank you.
No, thank you.
Otis! You fool! You let yourself get caught!
Oh, hush up, Orville.
Yeah, hush up. We're putting you and Ollie in with your brother.
No! To think we've been blaming everything on you putting him since 1917.
And that was our great granddaddy, Harvey Scroggs.
Hey, Big Mouth! And you let us blame the Ludlows all these years? Why, you no good thieving buffalo brain bunch of cowlips!
Norm, I suppose we owe you all the Ludlows an apology.
No, Emmett, we were both wrong. Think it's time to interview?
I sure do.
What's something cheering about?
The Putnam Ludlow Field is over for good.
That's wonderful.
It sure is. Here's one who saved the day.
Woo! Looks like Lily needed a new sheriff now.
I nominate Lester for the job.
I second the motion.
All in favor, say aye.
No!
I'm so glad that everything worked out. I must say that me and my family enjoyed our stay here at Cactus Pass. We sure had fun.
We'll always remember you.
I don't want to come home!
Why, you have Americans wear a pickup truck. You can all ride in the back.
I'm not riding in the back of any pickup truck.
Well, dear, then you can just walk.
Say goodbye to nice people, Sheriff.
You mean Otis? Sorry you folks ever came to this town.
You're sorry.
Let's go. Recreation time is over. Back to your step.
You know folks come and visit sometime.
Come on, Scrubs. I'm going to personally see you two smelly critters to jail. It was my nice meeting you folks. Send us a postcard from Las Vegas. Come on.
Oh, woman! That hurts!
Keep going. Come on, get it.
Thank you, all of you. We'll always remember Cactus Pass. And if you're ever in Boston, we'd love to have you stop by.
Just try to warn us first.
Well, Mr. Barrington, truck's all ready. And Mrs. Barrington, unless you want to get a mouthful of bugs, I suggest you keep your mouth shut.
Well, is everybody ready? Then Western ho!
If you got a mind to travel across the USA, make sure you do it up the American way.
We're gonna open these windows and take them away.